One of the most famous fighting units of World War II was known as Merrill's Marauders. They cut a road through Burma in 1944. They were actually on a suicide mission, but none of the men knew that. Well, wouldn't you know that a few of the men were stubborn enough to survive? They held a reunion last month. Our Dan Coughlin was there, and here's the story.
All of a sudden, a couple of snipers opened up on me. I'm looking for cover, and there's nothing out there, but I look down, there's a dead, stinking water buffalo. You could smell them. If you were on 117th Street on the west side, you could smell them at the public square. That's how bad it was. So I said, not now. So I dove behind him. And I'm laying there with that. My eyes were watering. It stunk so bad, it was just rolling down my eyes. And I'm laying there thinking, this is the day I'm going to die. So they sent in two P-51s, and they sprayed, come in about 5 or 10 minutes later, it seemed. They came in, they sprayed that whole hillside. I'm lucky I got out of there. I'm lucky I'm one of the survivors in this outfit. In fact, I'm lucky and honored to be a member of them. One of the greatest.
Junior O'Malley of Lakewood, Ohio, recalls the terror and the pride associated with being a member of Merrill's Marauders, perhaps the single most heralded American fighting unit of World War II. There were 3,000 of them originally who reopened the Burma Road against Japan's crack 18th Division in 1944. Half of them came back. About 400 of them are still alive. 125 got together last month at the Hilton Inn, just south of Cleveland, for their annual reunion. Their camaraderie is unusual, even for old soldiers.
We were in some pretty bad situations where we were. And everybody, whatever it was, we got to know we had to protect each other. And there were many cases where you depended on your brother, fellow marauder to help you out, which he did.
It was an unusual outfit to start with, and we've stayed together all these years. As a matter of fact, some of our children have even married children of marauders.
Ramona Johnson from Oklahoma, for you, this is not a reunion, this is a first meeting.
Last year in Tucson, we met, they were from Pennsylvania, and we were from Oklahoma. We wrote, we talked on the telephone and everything for all those years. For about 38 years. Last year in Tucson, Pauline and I got to meet each other, and it was just like we had met family.
Sergeant David Quaid of Duxbury, Massachusetts, was the Army combat photographer who filmed all of this action. His footage later was used in Victory at Sea, GI Diary, and other documentaries. In civilian life, he became an Emmy Award-winning cinematographer. He returns each year for the reunion.
Being able to handle a photographic assignment in Burma, made anything else in life seem easy.
You fought terrible monsoon rains that not even the mules could navigate
through.
No,
they could not. At one point, 17 mules had to be shot. When I first heard the gunfire, I thought we had run into a Japanese patrol, but it was just that the mules had fallen over the cliffs and they had to be put out of their misery. Even when the mules couldn't handle these incredible slopes and the slickness from the monsoon rains, that individual soldiers had to carry the 90-pound saddles up the mountains themselves. Someone said to me just this week, when he said, well, why are you going to this convention? I said, to meet my old friends who were so great. And he said, only an idealist is a volunteer. And these men were all idealists. They were the toughest soldiers I have ever met in my life. They were the best. They could endure anything. And that's what makes them a marauder.
They caught bullets and they caught disease. Almost every man contracted malaria and amoebic dysentery, and they came home with memories and more than that.
A machine gun got me in the head. I still have the two bullets in my head.
Every once in a while I have chills and so forth. It's whether it's from malaria or what it's from, I feel it's probably from malaria, but I always think about it when I get those chills.
And then while I was trying to crawl away, a 90-millimeter mortar took out my ankle.
It was pretty rough, and it was worse than it was on Guadalcanal.
I constantly live with headaches.
Put it very truthfully, it was a suicide mission, but we didn't know it.
Sergeant Toomey was putting a heavy machine gun into its cradle, suddenly turned to me and said, Dave, are you crazy? What are you doing walking up the trail?
Even now, after so many years, I still get particles in my helmet will break out in some part of my body.
I had to dive off the trail, and as I did, the Japanese soldier traversed with a machine gun and killed Toomey.
But we were supposed to be all wiped out.
This is 41 years later, and you still think about it.
Well, how can you help it? I mean, if you have any humanity in your being, you certainly have to consider the fact that someone, out of an act of kindness and charity, lost their life because of it.
Even Pope John Paul II recognized Merrill's Marauders. This is a copy of the telegram Junior O'Malley received from the Vatican. Holy Father informed of 39th annual reunion of Merrill's Marauders and wishes to express cordial greetings and assurances of prayers that surviving members of this military unit will rededicate themselves to the pursuit of peace in our world. With special remembrance of their fallen comrades, His Holiness invokes upon the men and their families the choicest blessings of Almighty God.
God every day that I'm able to be here and able to be standing here talking to you.
Merrill's Marauders have been holding reunions for the last 39 years, and Dan tells me the men are closer now than when they were in the same foxholes fighting for their lives. By the way, this beautiful room that I'm sitting in was designed by Ann Waters of the Mulberry Bush. Next up tonight on PM Magazine, we'll take a look at the boutique here at the Hope House.